Now, joining me is Ian Todd. He is running for Congress in Minnesota's 6th District. He's got a Republican incumbent. Ian, welcome to Rebel Headquarters.
Hey, Cenk, thanks for having me.
No problem, brother. Okay, so you've got a lot of interesting parts to your story. And first off, you decided, of all places, to move to Minnesota. Why did you do that?
Well, I mean, I had just finished my military service, 6 years in the Air Force, and well, I came from Arkansas. Part of the reason I joined the military was to get out of my hometown. I chose Minnesota partly because of my best friend, Ben Carollo, who was actually the person who turned me on to TYT as well. Well, he was my safety net here. He was the person that I knew in Minnesota, you know, so I could actually make it my home. I plan to go to school here. My wife's going to school here currently at St. Cloud State University, but well, the cards were a little bit differently for me, and I had the opportunity to run, and I took it.
All right, I got you. I don't know if you've heard of a state called California. We have really good weather. Anyway, okay.
Weather in Minnesota suits me just fine. Snow's not too bad.
All right, God bless. Hey, you're looking to represent those folks, so it makes sense. man, you actually chose Minnesota, so they should choose you. How's that for a slogan?
Hey, I like that.
Okay, so you're unopposed in the primary, so you're going to go take on the Republican for sure, right?
That's correct.
Okay, so that's certainly helpful. Talk to me about your incumbent there, Tom Emmer.
Yeah, well, let's see here. Tom Emmer is a man who loves to vote in favor for deregulating the banks. He's also a person who loves to try to take away environmental protections from our state. You know, for a lot of what he votes, you can see that he's just in lockstep with the rest of the Republicans. We're really sick of that type of politician. We want someone who actually serves people.
So, Ian, it's been a comfortably Republican seat for a while. Your issues appear to be solidly progressive, your policy stances. So we'll get to those in 1 second. But what's your battle plan for beating Emmer in this district in particular?
Well, I think the most important thing that we can remember is that we do the best when we run on our progressive values. And that's something that's been missing from the 6th District for quite some time. Now, yes, this has been a strong Republican district for quite some time, but in 2012, we actually came within 1 point of swinging the district the other way. And I have to remember that, and I have to remind people that we have the support here. They've just been not voting for the last few years. It's time to get them back to the polls.
That is interesting. It's interesting that you're unopposed, even though it's a district that as recently as 2012 was only a 1 point race. So you are not taking corporate PAC money, correct?
Correct.
Right. So he's gonna way outraise you, obviously. You might outraise him as small donors, but he's gonna bring in the big donors. So let's talk about your policy positions and see if they can make the difference. So what are your top priorities?
Well, my number one priority is getting the money out of politics. I've worked a little bit with Wolfpack in the past, but up here in Greater Minnesota, American Promise has a little more sway, and they've actually had the opportunity to talk to some county commissioners and push forward this idea of let's get the money out and let's do it state by state. So we're seeing a lot of victories right here in Minnesota, and we're hoping that we're going to be the next state to ask for a ratification to the Constitution.
Yeah, so American Promise is an excellent group. I just went to their conference just a couple of weekends ago. And so I love that you're working with them. That shows that you're a true progressive and looking to get money out of politics. So you have in your list of priorities, you want to stop trade with nations that allow slave or child labor. What do you mean by that?
So there's a lot of nations that don't actively try to prevent any slave or child labor. Sometimes they even accept it. And I think that one of the important things that we need to do is whenever we talk about trade with other countries, we cannot accept trade from countries that so openly allow this. Sometimes it's hard in capitalist system to actually be able to buy anything ethically. And the best that we can possibly do as a country is to make sure that we are providing those ethics if they're not going to exist from the companies themselves.
Mm-hmm. So now the right wing would say, wait, now that's some of our top allies. I mean, there's an excellent case to be made that Saudi Arabia and Qatar use slave labor. And They bring in people from outside the country, they take their passports, they make them work, etc. So are you proposing that we stop trading with those countries?
I'm proposing that we certainly take a look at what we have done in the past. And you know, certainly when we're talking about trade with Saudi Arabia, I would not mind selling less weapons to that country. Not at all. I think that that would be in everybody's best interest, quite frankly.
So you're in favor of subsidized universal childcare. First of all, flesh that out for me. How would that work? And then we'll talk a little bit more about it. Go ahead.
Oh, care is such an important topic. You know, it comes from childcare, it comes from healthcare, it comes from elder care, all types of different care. We have to subsidize this just because it's a human right, especially for childcare. We're talking about a lot of people choose not to work because childcare is so expensive. So it is a detriment on our economy. It would be far better if we actually had real subsidization for any type of care at all, childcare, elder care, healthcare. All of these things are so incredibly important, and it only serves to make us a stronger country whenever we're willing to subsidize. Will that cost money? Of course it will, but there are so many places where we can draw from. We need to undo this disastrous tax plan, and we also need to take a look at military spending, because there's a lot of money to be saved there without having to harm our troops.
Well, that sounds dangerous. That sounds like you turn us into one of those incredibly happy socialist countries in Northern Europe.
They have that now.
Yeah. And and by the way, if we provide universal childcare, the other thing that it does is improve the economy. One, it creates those jobs, but more importantly, two, it frees the parents to actually go get jobs. And unfortunately, almost all the families now have to have both parents working. And sometimes they can't because they need to take care of the kids, and they don't have money for that. So it puts them in a no-win situation. This actually would help to create a lot more jobs, and I think help the people in Minnesota.
So now, exactly.
Yeah. So now let's talk about tactics a little bit. So you have very limited amount of money. It's again not an undoable district, especially in a wave, right? And if you've got a real wave, you certainly could win this race. So I'm positive that your message is the right one. A progressive message, we've tested it 100 different times in 100 different ways in 100 different places, and it tests incredibly well, including with independent voters and even sometimes right-leaning voters. They want Medicare for all too, because they're literally dying out there. So, but how do you get that message out, Ian?
Well, the best way to get that message out is to just go out and talk to people. For me, it's door knocks. That's what I do with the vast majority of my time. It's doing town halls. It's about actually being able to communicate with people in a direct way. And yes, money certainly helps. So, I mean, we're sitting at about 10 grand more raised at this point in time in our election than the previous person running in 2016. And so we're feeling pretty positive about that. It allows us to get a lot of Facebook messages out there. It allows us to use Google to spread the message, because I certainly can't hit every single door. But that's why it's so important to have a grassroots organization with a lot of volunteers who like this message, who believe in this message, and are willing to go out for it.
All right, and your website's iantoddforcongress.com. To donate, you go to actblue.com/donate/iantodd, and to volunteer, iantoddforcongress.com/volunteer. So obviously you can get to it from the website. Any interesting or crazy stories from the campaign trail?
Oh man, interesting or crazy ones. You know, certainly I've had some interesting opponents in the past, though I don't want to say anything negative about anybody. But they were certainly adventures, sitting up there and answering questions with them. You know, other than that, it's been an adventure getting out in CD6, really meeting my neighbors and learning who everyone is, and just being flabbergasted that this district has been red for so long when there are so many amazing progressives out there ready to fight.
All right, let's go round them up. Ian Todd, running for Congress, thank you for joining us at Rebel Headquarters. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Cenk.